This is our main framework. These two wires are the heaviest. The rest of the piece will be done in regular filigree wire. This time, we're cutting a piece and bending it unevenly so that one end is longer than the other. You can get a good sharp point on your bend by using the inside of the jaws of your pliers to crimp it. Once we have the double spirals, we're going to fit it into the corner at the base of the frame. Now, if it doesn't fit exactly, don't worry about it. In fact, make it so that the only real place you're going to be soldering is the point, the V, the end of the V. Again, you flux it. And you pick up that solder, heat it up, place the solder, and it flows. We are also going to solder another edge of the gold-filled wire in place. And as you can see, we can also use the solder pick to put pressure on a piece of wire to make it sit or closer to the piece we're trying to solder. Sometimes you don't get it the first time, and you will have to go back and forth and solder two or three times. Normally, if you weren't using a solder pick, you'd have to stop, pickle, rinse, and start again. With pieces like this, it's more efficient to use the solder pick. Now, we reshape the other two spirals the way we want them. We get them ready, and we go through the process again. And for those of you who get frustrated because you find yourself melting the wires, it happens to me too. I've been doing it for over 20 years, and I still occasionally mess up. So what do you do? Two options. You can pull out that entire double spiral, or you can improvise. I just clipped it and curled it a little bit smaller than the original design, and we'll compensate for it. So again, flux, and solder, and pickle. This time, it worked. When you're working three-dimensionally, you need to make sure you connect as many spots as you can for structural integrity. So you see, it's starting to take shape. Now, we're going to add another double spiral, but this time, we're just going to bend it and crimp it. We're not going to make the spirals yet. For one thing, we're going to crimp it like this, but we're also going to bend it so that it fits into the curve on the other side of the piece. It sits down inside it. Fluxing, and again soldering. Again, we use the solder pick both to deliver the solder to where we need it, but also to adjust the wire as need be. See? This time, it's soldered. Sometimes leftover flux will make your piece stick to your soldering surface. Now you see, unfortunately, my camera angle was not so good here, but once you have the anchor point soldered, you can use your pliers and shape the spirals afterwards, fitting them into place. This is very helpful when you are doing a three-dimensional piece. Solder time again! You'll notice we lost the solder and were able to pick it up again with the solder pick. We're going to have to push down on this wire to make it touch the gold-filled wire beneath. Something you obviously couldn't do with your fingers, but can easily do with your solder pick. Be careful not to put too much abrupt pressure. You can break the wires this way. Now it's starting to look like a filigree piece. Now, we're going to add another little wire over by the piece that we originally melted. We're going to stick the starting end of the spiral,
the curved
in
double
under.
Spiral.
And have the outer loop touching the other spiral, which was too short, the one that we originally melted. Pick up and place that solder. Coax it to go where you want to with your flame. And connect the other connection. Sometimes it's good just to do a general once-over as well, just to make sure all your solder is nice and even. Now you can see we're almost to the point of being done. Though my original design called for two small round settings, I decided to use one of my pear-shaped settings, which I use in many of my designs these days. You'll see that it sits a little bit at an angle because of the three-dimensional nature of the design. Again, we pick up the solder with the solder pick and put it where we want it. Oops, I moved the setting, so now we use the solder pick to actually nudge the setting and even lift it slightly into place. All this takes practice, but you'll get it.